Mr. Commissioner, Carlos Moedas, Head of the EC Representation in Portugal, Doutora Sofia Alves, Councillor Nuno Pitera Lopes, Professor and Dean Daniel Traça, representatives of the security forces and students of the security forces, Mr. João Proença, ladies and gentlemen, dear participants, welcome to the fourth edition of the Youth Summit. Notice that I did not say welcome to the fifth edition of the Cyril Conferences. I did not say it because today the Youth Summit is an autonomous event on itself, a set of conferences and dialogue between and with youngsters from all over the world, young people who care about their future and that of the entire world, young people who realize daily that the possibility of changing the world is in their own hands, youngsters that together design this entire program and choose what should be discussed and what is truly important. Important not for us here on the front row, men and women with careers and families and choices that have already been made, but for them. Important for you, the young people who are present here today. This is the Youth Summit with more participants up to this day. Today, almost 1,000 of you will discuss the future of the European Union, the concept of borders, the health of our planet, and what can each and every one of us do to help the others and to help changing the world. You will hear about experiences so far away from our realities that you will need to control yourselves not to believe that this is a dream, or perhaps a nightmare. And you will do it with a European Commissioner, a Nobel Prize winner, authors, professors, people that come from the ground and they experience horror in the ground, and entrepreneurs with proven results in effectively changing the world. This is a truly impressive program, only made possible thanks to the support of our academic partners, to which I would also like to take this opportunity to thank. Especially, I would like to thank Professor Dirk, our host, and our inspiration. Thank you, Professor. I have told you this before lately. You have been an inspiration for the Youth Summit and for its concept as it stands today. And it's an honor for us to have you again as our host. The Youth Summit is also an experience. And I don't mean just an experience, like so many events and meetings claim to be. Quite to the contrary. We have a living proof right here, and that is Mr. Amish Lashmidas, our youth representative, who started out some years ago as a youth ambassador, like so many of you who are here with us today. Your dedication and will to learn led you to this stage today. To be truly honest, it is to Mr. Amish that we should all be thankful today. The Youth Summit of 2017 will be an absolute success, and a big part of that success is due to the impressive effort that Amish put to this summit. So thank you, Amish. Amish is only one successful example of our projects, one amongst others. Only a few days ago, I learned of a loving couple that met each other during another of our projects, the Global Boomerang. Some of you here today were also present on this year's edition that finished yesterday. And the Cyril Conferences Summit on the 31st of May, we will have with us a young adult, a speaker, on the panel regarding the control of the EU external borders and strategic partnerships. His name is Pedro Espírito Santo, and he's now a legal officer at European Commission. Before joining the EC, he had already worked at United Nations headquarters in New York. he too was present in one of our summits. Actually, he joined the first edition of Cyril Conferences in 2009 as a high school student. Now, he will be one reputed speaker of the Cyril Conferences, and I am sure that that experience helped him become what he is today. These are small examples of what it is that we want to inspire with the Youth Summit, a summit that works as the basis for the preparation of the future, a future that is up to you, a summit that would not happen if it not had been for your interest and your will to change the world. And so, I am also very thankful for your presence here and for your enthusiasm. Thank you for being a part of one of the greatest dialogues in the world. And finally, if we are all here, we must be grateful to one very important institution, which is the municipality of Cascais. The municipality gathers people that many years ago had the dream of making Cascais a stage for global dialogue. Mr. Councillor Nuno Pitera Lopes, if you and your colleagues had not believed in the Youth Summit since its very first edition, then a loving couple would not have met. Amish would not be here today, being the most relevant organizer of the Youth Summit, and Pedro Espírito Santo would not have had an experience that, for all we know, might have changed his life. Dear Nuno, and I extend this recognition to the Mayor, Carlos Carreiras, and to the Deputy Mayor, Miguel Pinto Luz, if you had not believed in the future generations as the driving wheel for change, we would never have had the chance to create impact and to dream of changing the world. Thank you. And thank you all, once again, for being a part of the Youth Summit and the Cyril Conferences. I truly hope you have a wonderful experience. Let the works begin. Thank you.